Thank you. Well, good evening and Merry Christmas. It is my joy to be able to welcome all of you here to First Baptist Church in Arlington. My name is Alan Lowe, and I am the Associate Pastor of Music and Worship here, and which basically means I have the privilege of being able to work with all the musicians in our church. And we've been working on this program, this concert, for a while, and we are just thrilled that you have come out tonight to share this time with us as we just enjoy the season of Christmas. And I was telling the group last night that this is my family's first Christmas in Texas, and we are just thrilled to be here, even though it was 75 degrees yesterday. We're not quite used to that, but it's cooling down a little bit tonight, and we're just excited to be able to welcome all of you this evening. And one of the things that I love most about Christmas is the wonderful songs of Christmas. So I want to invite you to stand together with us tonight. We're going to sing one of the great Christmas carols, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Thank you. As it was told by the prophets of long ago, God himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Hear, O Israel, God is with us. He has come to save us. The angel Gabriel was sent by God to the Virgin Mary, saying, "Do not be afraid, for you have found favor with God. You shall bring forth a son. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end."
Everything inside me cries for order. And everything inside me wants to hide. Is this shadow an angel or a warrior? If God is pleased with me, why am I so terrified? Someone tell me I am only dreaming. Somehow help me see with heaven's eyes. And before my head agrees, my heart is on its knees. Holy is He, blessed am I.
Thank you.
An angel of the Lord appeared also to Joseph, son of David, saying, Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit, and she will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. And Mary and Joseph traveled to Bethlehem, and while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And with this child, God's redemption plan was born.
Purest light, Lord on high, is here tonight, stepping through this sacred sky. Suddenly our eyes behold heaven's perfect plan. Unfold, Son of God.
Son of God, my God, timeless one, steps into time. Who could dream of such a
of the only begotten of the Father, And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and singing. So the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill to men." Hallelujah.
Thank you.
in the beginning, the Word already existed. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He existed in the beginning with God, and God created everything through Him, and nothing was created except through Him. The Word gave life to everything that was created, and His life brought light to everyone. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never extinguish it. The one who is the true light, who gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. He came into the very world He created, but the world didn't recognize Him. He came to His own people, and even they rejected Him. But to all who believed Him and accepted Him, He gave the right to become children of God. So the Word became human and made His home among us.
Thank you. Well, I'm Dennis Wiles, and I'm the pastor here at First Baptist Arlington, and I just want to welcome you to a routine Sunday evening. I said that to our folks last night, a routine Saturday evening, but it has truly been an incredible weekend. Haven't you been blessed tonight? I'm so grateful. Thank you, guys. Now, tonight, we have heard this beautiful expression of Christmas. In fact, these musicians and these technicians, they've demonstrated their talent tonight, and what we've all attempted to do is to tell a story. It's been our desire tonight to communicate an ancient story. In fact, it's a story that we believe that God Himself has written. The God of the universe, the God who created everything that is, also inspired these composers to write this music. And He has gifted these talented musicians to communicate it to us tonight so that we might celebrate God's greatest gift. And indeed, it is an ancient story. In fact, the Apostle Paul says in the New Testament that this story actually began before the foundation of the world. But what's unique and remarkable about this story is that on the one hand, it's an ancient story, but on the other hand, it's a very contemporary story. In fact, it's a current story. It's a story that continues to be written even to this day. Because God has chosen in His sovereignty to write me and you into the script of this cosmic drama. So while it's an ancient story, it's a contemporary story. As a matter of fact, it's our story. It's my story. It's your story. Because God has chosen to give us a remarkable opportunity as human beings. He has designed us and created us in His image. And He's given us the privilege of reflecting His glory on planet Earth. It truly is a remarkable opportunity that human beings all across time, all across the world, have the opportunity to bear the image of God and reflect the glory of God on planet Earth. And yet, this story, as beautiful as it is, it has not worked out as well as God intended. In fact, the story of humanity is a remarkable story. However, it is also a sad tale of our inability to fulfill our assignment and actually accomplish the very things for which you and I have been designed. Because we don't adequately bear the image of God. And unfortunately, we have fallen short of the glory of God. And that's why the human story is tarnished and it's littered by abuse and abandonment and persecution and oppression and imprisonment and exile and violence and yes, even death. But the good news that we are communicating tonight is that God did not just sit idly by while the human story has been played out on planet Earth. God actually has chosen to respond to the human dilemma. And in fact, that's what the Christmas story is all about. The Christmas story is God's personal intervention into the human drama. In fact, God has chosen personally to intervene. The Apostle John tells the Christmas story like this. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And in Him was life, and this life was the light of all mankind. And the Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us. And we beheld His glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. The writer of Hebrews in the New Testament, he puts it like this. He says, the Son is the exact representation of God's being. He is the radiance of God's glory. So did you catch what the writer of Hebrews is saying? He says that Jesus reflected the glory of God, and Jesus is the one who has fully borne the image of God. In other words, Jesus came to demonstrate to us just how it could be done. Jesus stepped out of eternity, came down from heaven, robed Himself in human flesh, and willingly and voluntarily submitted himself to the limitations of humanity to show us how we could be redeemed and how every human being could actually live fully into their potential and they could actually bear God's image and reflect God's glory on planet Earth. That is really the Christmas story. It's about Jesus. Jesus came to set the captive free. Jesus came to bring an answer to our dilemma. And Jesus has answered our brokenness with healing. Jesus has addressed violence with his gift of peace. And Jesus has even conquered death with life. And that's why this story is so compelling. It's a story about the Savior who has been born. It's a story that is filled with good news, just like the angel announced on that very first Christmas night. There is to be good news, and it's for all the people, because a Savior has been born, Christ the Lord. And the angels began to proclaim, "Glory to God in the highest, on earth peace and goodwill toward men." The composers who brought this music into being, they sought to honor Jesus. These musicians tonight who have performed this music, these technicians who have surrounded them, all of us together, we are seeking to honor Jesus. Because the Christmas story is about him. It's about Jesus, the Son of God, the Son of Man, the image of the invisible God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, the one who is going to rule God's kingdom, and of his reign there will be no end, and the zeal of the Lord God Almighty will accomplish it. This story that we know as the Christmas story, it's a compelling one. It's actually an enduring one. Because for us, we know that Jesus is at the heart of all of this music. In fact, Jesus is at the heart of the message of Christmas. He is the reason that this music has been composed. And what we want you to know tonight is that not only is Jesus at the heart of all this music, and not only is Jesus at the heart of this message, what we want to make sure you know tonight is that Jesus is at the door of your heart. And if you have never met him personally, if you have never embraced Jesus Christ as your Savior, it's our prayer that you will do so even tonight, and that you will invite him into your life. And then once you do that, then your life can take on the meaning and the fulfillment and the significance that only Jesus Christ can offer a human being. That's our hope. That's our prayer, that you will invite Jesus into your life as we have. And once you do that, then your story will be told in eternity. Because when you do that, your story will take on great significance because you've joined yours to his. May it be so for you. God bless you and Merry Christmas.
The first light of a new day, no one knew he had arrived. Things continued as they had been, while a newborn softly cried. But the heavens, wrapped in wonder, knew the meaning.
as his mother held him closely, it was hard to understand that her baby, not yet speaking, was the word of God to man. He would tell them of his kingdom, but their hearts would not believe. They would hate him, and in anger they would nail him to a tree.
Then I heard what sounded like a great multitude, like the roar of rushing waters, and like loud peals of thunder shouting, "Hallelujah! For our Lord God Almighty reigns. Let us rejoice and be glad and give him the glory."
Lord God, hear
And everyone said amen. Amen. Thank you so much for being here. And I just want to say, as the pastor of this crowd, thank y'all for all your hard work. Great job praising our Lord tonight and last night. I love y'all. It was really incredible. Wow. You know, one of my good friends, Kay Owens, is fond of saying at the end of a concert or a performance, "That's all we know." But you know what? I know better. That's not true. They know a whole lot more than what they shared tonight. And so you'll notice in your program, we'll invite you to other events this Christmas season and on into next year. On that last page of the program, there's an invite for you. And we would love for you to come back and be a part of the life of First Baptist Arlington. But I hope this has at least helped you a little bit kick off the Christmas season. So God bless you. Merry Christmas and good night. Great job, Alan.